My 2022 prediction, my hairline will continue to recede. You can take that one to the bank. Is there a line on that in Vegas? Conventional wisdom and history points to a disappointing 2022 at the ballot box for Democrats. The first midterm election of a newly elected president is almost always bad news for his party in Congress. Republicans lost 40 seats in the House in 2018, Donald Trump's first midterm, while Democrats dropped 63 seats in 2010, Barack Obama's first midterm. Pretty ugly out there, folks. In fact, the president's party has lost, on average, nearly 27 House seats and more than 3 Senate seats in the 19 midterm elections between 1946 and 2018, which, if history holds in 2022, would put Democrats out of the House and the Senate majorities. So there's plenty of reasons to see dark clouds for Democrats on the horizon come 2022. Sidebar. Democratic fears about losing control of the Senate are driving some liberals, led by New York Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, to call for Supreme Court Justice Stephen Breyer to step down this summer so that President Joe Biden can have a Democratic-controlled Senate in place to appoint a replacement. But according to Alan Abramowitz, a political science professor at Emory University, go ahead, Georgia, all is not lost for Democrats, or at least all is not lost yet. Abramowitz released his first 2022 election forecast in early June and found some reason for Democratic hope. Quote, a model using the generic ballot and seat exposure shows that a single-digit lead on the generic ballot would give Democrats a good chance to keep control of the Senate, he wrote, adding, given the expected impact of redistricting, however, Democrats probably need a larger lead to keep control of the House, end quote. Okay, let's unpack this all. A little bit. It's a lot of packages. Election forecasting, especially in the last decade or so, has been taken over by statistical models like Abramowitz's. The most famous and infamous of the election modelers is one Nate Silver. So the way these models work, and I'm shorthanding it a bit here, it's only a 5-minute video, is that a series of factors that have traditionally been good indicators of how elections are decided are plugged in, and a series of results are spit out. Not gonna spit. It makes sense, right? Right. No spinning. So the Abramowitz model is primarily powered by two inputs. One is the generic ballot question. So it's a common question asked in national polls that usually goes along these lines. If the election was held today, would you vote for the Democratic or Republican candidate for the House? No names of specific candidates are used, hence generic. While the generic ballot is pretty useless in predicting the outcome of any individual race, the question has generally served as a good indicator of what way the national winds are blowing and which party is benefiting from those winds. Think of it sort of like a political weather vane that you have on your house. Factor two, input two in the Abramowitz model, the raw number of seats both parties are defending. So in Abramowitz's model, he sets that at 222 Democratic House seats out of 435 and 14 Senate seats out of 34 up in 2022. While there are two vacant seats in the House right now, that's Florida's 20th and Ohio's 11th, both of those are strongly Democratic and will, barring some sort of wild catastrophe, elect a new member of Congress who is a Democrat. Now, depending on which side then has the edge in the generic ballot, Abramowitz's model spits out a variety of outcomes. Sorry, Mom. The rosiest of those outcomes for Democrats, a 10-point lead in the generic ballot in the fall, would result in a gain of 2 seats for House Democrats and a 3-seat pickup for Senate Democrats, and obviously they would still hold a majority in both chambers. The worst-case scenario for Democrats, a 10-point edge for Republicans in the generic ballot, would, according to the Abramowitz model, result in a 32-seat loss by Democrats in the House and a 1-seat loss in the Senate. In both cases, they would lose the majority. Now, where does the generic ballot stand now, you ask? Well, not a lot of pollsters are asking that question, it being many months before the 2022 midterm elections right now, but a Quinnipiac University, Go Connecticut, national poll in May did give Democrats a 9-point edge in the generic ballot. But again, the election isn't until November 2022, so grain of salt and all that. Plus, as Abramowitz notes rightly in his analysis, his model doesn't take into account redistricting, the decennial redrawing of all 435 congressional districts in the country. And as David Wasserman, a nonpartisan redistricting expert, has pointed out, Republicans will have complete line drawing control over 187 House seats, while Democrats will enjoy that same total authority over just 75 districts. The likely gains for Republicans from redistricting then could make it so that Democrats would need to lose just 2 to 3 competitive seats to lose the majority in 2022, which, given historic trends, could be a very hard line to hold. It's not really a line here. Still, Abramowitz's model provides Democrats some hope. Quote, despite their extremely narrow majorities, the forecasts show that Democrats have a reasonable chance of keeping control of both chambers in the midterm elections if they maintain at least a narrow lead on the generic ballot, he concludes. If is the key word there. And that is the point. We make new point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.